Hi there, welcome to edupediaworld.com. You're watching the videos on probability. So in this video again we'll discuss some of the extra questions related to probability which are seen generally in the examination. So again I'm telling you, you have to watch this part of the video very carefully again, right? So let's get started with the first question, which is question number one. Now the question says that two coins are tossed 1000 times and the outcomes are recorded as below, right? So these are the outcomes of when the two coins are tossed 1000 times and the following data is recorded, right? So this is the data. Let's say these are the number of heads 2, 1 and 0, right? And this is a frequency. Let's say for 2, this is frequency is 200. So this is a kind of data is always given, as you know already, right? Now based on this information, the probability for at most one head. So we need to find the probability there is at most one head. So what is the meaning of at most? Let's discuss. At most one head, right? It means either 0 or 1, right? So either 0 or 1. So but it should not be greater than 1. So this, you have to be very careful what the question is asking, because that's all about the probability, as I'm again telling you, right? So let's see how we can solve this question. So first of all, we need to write frequency, let's, or we can say number of times the head comes at most one, right? Most one times. So this will come out to be, so we need to add this data, right? So this will come out to be 550 plus 250, right? So when you add them, so let's say we add them 550 plus 50, so it will come out to be 800. So this is 8, right? So now we can say that the probability that there is at most one head will be equals to number of times the head comes, right, upon total frequency, right? So this will come out to be 800 upon 1000, so this and this get cancelled, so this will come out to be 0.8. So this is how we have to solve these type of question, right? So let's discuss the next question, which is question number 2. Now the question says that 80 bulbs are selected at random from a lot and their lifetime in hours are recorded in the form of frequency table given below. So this is the lifetime of 80 bulbs, right? It's recorded in a table. Let's say lifetime of 300 hours, how many bulbs that have a life of 300 hours? So it's 10. So this is the kind of data is given, right? Now one bulb is selected at random from the lot, the probability that its life is 1150 hours is, so we need to find that the probability there is life of 1150 hours. Now if you can see from the data, there is no value for 1150, right? So this means for the 1150 the frequency is 0, as you can see properly, right? So this is how you have to interpret the data, right? So over here we can write frequency or number of bulbs that have life of 1150 hours is 0, right? So we can say that the probability that life is 1150 hours equals to number of bulbs that have life of 1150 hours upon total frequency, right? So this will come out to be 0 upon 80. So the probability is 0. So this is how we have to solve the various types of question, right? So let's discuss the next question, which is question number 3. Now the question says that in a sample study of 642 people, it was found that 514 people have a high school certificate, right? And if a person is selected at random, the probability that the person has high school certificate, right? So we need to find that the probability that a person has a high school certificate. So it's very easy question. Let's do it quickly now. So we can write, first of all, sample study, you can say, or total sample study is 642 people, right? And we can write over here then number of people that have high school certificate is 514, right? So then we can say that the probability that a person has high school certificate will be equals to number of people that have school certificate upon total sample study, right? So this will come out to be 514 upon 642, right? Now when you simplify 514 and 642, so the answer that comes out to be 257 upon 321. So this is the probability that the people has high school certificate. So this is how we have solved all the probability questions so far till now. To this video we have discussed all the various types of possible questions that can come in the examination for probability. I hope the questions are helpful to you. So in the end I can say that thank you once again for watching this video on edupediaworld.com. Keep watching further videos. Have a nice day ahead.